So now we're going to do another Taisabaki drill that we brought back from Japan. Your partner's going to stand facing you. And when we go to push somebody in the past, we just walk up, use your arms, and launch them, right? This is all right. This is a way to push. A different hitting with taijutsu, with your whole body. Here's the new drill. I'm just going to do it and not explain it much. Keep your arms locked out. When I take my first step, I want to have contact with the person. Instead of letting my arms bend and then push, my second step as I step up is what is going to do the push. So your partner doesn't do anything fancy. You can connect with the first step and then just step up. You don't have to push him hard. You don't have to push him far. You can push him if he just stays there, and I can connect from behind. First step, touch. Second step, push. So this is a really cool way to start thinking of a different way of pushing. It's using your stepping to do the push. Or you could think of it as, first one is the fist, second one does the hit. So this is using taijutsu to hit with instead of muscle strength. So it's another way. So after you've got that whole drill down where you're doing a touch and push, you do another one, touch and push. I did an anticipational one. So this is a neat one where your partner kind of braces for it because you like come in with this big thing and their body gets ready for this huge push and this shock to happen, but nothing happens. So there's this dynamic that's created here. It's like Mitsubishi, it's a falsehood in the mind. You've just taken their mind for a second, and that's when you can turn and move, put it into a different move. So the drill is straight arms, touch, first step, second step, push. Your partner does it. First step, touch. Second step, push. Touch, push. Touch, push. Good, that was nice. So that feeling of getting a touch and then the push coming from that second step through is what you really want. All the time you're doing this, you should be thinking about, when I'm stepping, are my shoulders moving to side to side? Am I telegraphing? Am I telegraphing to come up to get the touch? I want to use the other training drill that we have already used, where I'm leaning forward, stepping, and then pushing with the second. So this is a whole nother thing. Build upon what you've already learned. Let them all come together then. So take this drill, try it with a partner, go front, back, side and side. It's it'll start to expand what's happening with your taijutsu. We've already taken it to the next level at the dojo by doing the same thing with weapon in the hand. So, first step, touch. Second step, push. This could be a thrust. I could be using my hands, but I'm just using my body, my taijutsu, to get that to happen. This type of movement is a real fundamental way of moving. And you'll start to see it in all the top shihan in Japan when you start to break down, why is this happening? What's going on? And it's another little insight to be able to see deeper into ninjutsu.
So building off that same drill that Mark was teaching, where Felix is standing in Shizen, I'm standing in Shizen, and I load weight onto one side, have my arms up. My arms should be totally extended, not bent for this. Right, weight shifts forward, falling in. See how far I am from Felix? So at this point, my distancing is off. So whenever we're doing this, we should also be practicing, okay, with my step and my arm reach, at what point do I make that light contact? Right here, weight shifts forward, small step. Now I've just very lightly touched Felix. This is the correct distance for this particular drill. So as my back foot steps up, Felix just gets pushed very, very lightly. So again, starting out here, weight shifts, falls forward, stepping in. For now, we're breaking it down into two separate steps, right? Just for the sake of learning your distance and learning how to fall, right? One, two. Ultimately, this is one step. So here, weight shifts, falls forward, touch, and move. So it becomes smooth. Once you have this kind of smooth motion, one, two, that's when you can start playing with letting off the pressure. Right? So get your distance, if you're where the weight is, one, two. Set your weight, forward, one, two. And his body shifts slightly forward. So this is something to be playing with along with this drill. It's something you need to be thinking about after you've done it for a little while and have kind of a basic understanding.